and welcome to the Free Gift Podcast, originating from the Free Gift Gospel Mission. The Free Gift Gospel Mission is an independent Bible-believing church preaching Jesus Christ as man's only provision for redemption and salvation. We are located at 1025 Maple Street in Kingsport, Tennessee, on the corner of Maple and Brook. This podcast is a Christ-centered ministry reaching out to souls with the love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you for joining us. Save me, buried, he carried my sins far away,
rising, he justified freely forever. I was recently asked the question, do I get nervous before I preach? Well, the truthful answer to that question is yes, I do. I do get nervous before I preach. Even after 20 years of preaching from the pulpit, there's always some bit of nervousness that I have to contend with. It isn't always to the level of my knees knocking together, but there is always some level of nervousness there. When you're handling the Word of God, it's a very serious, very important matter. And you don't want to say or do anything to misrepresent the truth. You don't want to cast a negative light on the testimony of Christ by your own ignorance. And the gravity of the situation does have the potential to make me a little bit nervous, just to be honest. But that's where we have to realize that God's preachers are to be bold and courageous. And we need to remember that we are depending upon the Lord and His power, and not depending upon ourselves. And I don't know how it is for other preachers out there, but for me, I tend to get more nervous in front of smaller congregations than larger congregations. I do get nervous with larger congregations as well, but the smaller ones are the ones for me that I'll be most likely to have to deal with some level of nervousness. And I guess the reason for that is because the smaller congregations tend to be far more personal. For example, if you're preaching to 1,000 people, which I've never done in a church setting, but for the sake of illustrating this point, if there's 1,000 people there and someone gets up to go to the restroom, well, you probably won't even notice. If there's 1,000 people there and someone leans over and whispers to their neighbor, you might not even see it. But if you're preaching to a congregation of 5 people and someone gets up to go to the restroom, you tend to notice that. And if you're not very careful, it has the potential to be distracting to you, and you might take your focus off of your preaching for just a moment. If you're preaching to 5 people and 2 of them are whispering back and forth, you'll probably notice something like that, and it might distract you. Of course, you have to be prepared for anything, and you have to have your mind and your heart fixed on the Lord so that it doesn't distract you. But too often, that's not the case, even for preachers. That's why it's crucial to spend some time in prayer before you get up to preach the Word of God, and ask the Lord to help you to keep your focus on delivering His Word, and then just leave the rest up to Him. He already knows what distractions are going to be there. He already knows what distractions lie ahead. We just need to be steadfast, stay the course, and follow through with the work at hand. So, what other tips could I give to young preachers other than to spend time in prayer before you stand to preach the Word of God? Well, of course, you need to saturate your heart and your mind with the Word of the Lord. And that really goes without saying, but maybe we need to say it anyway. When you've been studying the Word of God and you've been pondering Scripture, when you've been nourishing your soul with the truth of the Word of God, that will go a long way toward helping you to overcome those nervous jitters. And here's something else from my 20 years of preaching experience that might be helpful to young preachers out there. And I haven't polled and interviewed other preachers on this, and I've not been reading case studies and internet articles. I'm just stating this from my own experience in dealing with being nervous before I stand up to preach. I found that if I just get started preaching,
if I can just get started, the Lord has never failed to stand with me. Once I open my mouth and I get those first few words out, the Lord sees fit somehow to bring His message forth. And I'm not saying that we start the preaching in our own power and then God takes it from there. No, we can't even get started without Him. That's why I stated previously that we need to spend some time in prayer before we preach. We need to saturate our hearts and minds with the Word of God before we ever start preaching. But when you know that your God is faithful, and when you know that He'll go with you no matter what you face in life, that does a lot to help you keep those nervous jitters in check. This is Pastor Vern. Thanks for listening.
Hands that heal nations stretched out on a tree and took the nest for me.
Thank you for listening to the Free Gift Podcast. If you would like more information about our church, please visit us online at www.freegiftgospelmission.wordpress.com. Our service times are as follows: Sunday school for all ages at 10 a.m., morning worship is at 11 a.m., Sunday evening at 6 p.m., and Wednesday night at 7 p.m. We are located at 1025 Maple Street in Kingsport, Tennessee, and we welcome all visitors. If you would like to correspond via email, you may email me, Pastor Vern Hall, at freegiftgospelmission@yahoo.com, or you may write to Pastor Vern Hall, 3301 Martin Farm Road, Johnson City, Tennessee, 37601. We look forward to seeing you at the Free Gift Gospel Mission, where the gospel is preached and the Lord Jesus Christ is praised. Until next time, may God's blessings be upon you.